I'm honored to welcome Xavier de Blotto, CIO of Havas Media. What I find very interesting is that Havas Media set up a global governance model with strong local involvement to develop its automation strategy. So, Xavier, could you please introduce yourself and tell us more about your responsibility into this project?
So my name is Xavier de Blotto. I am the global CIO of Havas Media, which is the media division of the Havas Group, which is one of the largest global communication network, which employs around 20,000 employees worldwide. And I am responsible for the RPA agenda within Havas Media.
Thank you, Xavier. Could you explain what led you down the path to automation?
So automation for us is a must. The advertising industry has evolved a lot over the past years. You may have heard about programmatic advertising, which is a way to serve an ad in an automatic way to your laptop, to your mobile. And in fact, we worked in a very automated way with our media partners. And what we want to achieve is to spread all this automation with our internal processes. So that's why we decided to launch this RPA journey.
So Havas decided to set up a global governance. Why do you feel it is important to centralize automation across the organization?
So we decided, as you say, to launch a global governance, a global infrastructure, which serves both the global operations and the local ones. Because we are in an industry where part of the work is done at global level, but many operations are done locally. So it's important to balance our operations at global and local level. But we wanted to have global standards, global infrastructure, and global way to operate RPA in order to have a common language between the global teams and the countries.
And so, how do you manage to involve countries and or employees in automation?
So Havas Media is a global network, but as I said before, lots of the processes are run locally, especially processes around traditional media, TV, print, radio, where all the partners are mainly local ones. So in that case, operations are mainly local. And if you want to run an important to count on the country to set up all the new processes with RPA at local level. So the way we engage countries is mainly information. We explain what RPA is about, and we try to engage them with a clear example. At the end of the day, what we ask them is to provide us with a clear example of a process which may be a pain point for them. We try to automate it at global level. We give it back to the country tests and understands what RPA is about. And that's the way we manage to engage the countries, because at the end of the day, we need countries to be very, very involved in RPA.
So how did you decide where to start with automation? Which type of processes did you begin with?
So we started with our finance operations, because most of the processes are very common from one country to the others, reporting processes, tax declaration, invoice reconciliation processes, which are quite heavy in terms of manual workload, and there was really big opportunity to improve them. That's why we decided to start with finance, and also because I thought it's very important to engage our CFOs, country CFOs, to let them know about RPA so that CFOs are aligned with this strategy and help us to spread it afterwards in all the organization.
We also commonly heard that from our customers that automation can drive cultural change in the organization. How do you think automation can effectively drive cultural change?
So this project, this journey, will lead us to efficiency, to reduction of low-value added task. And in fact, when you run an RPA agenda, an RPA journey, you challenge everything. You challenge all your processes, and you detect improvements, and you design new processes. And that's transformation. That's really what drives the cultural changes, because you need to challenge everything which is in place in order to go for improvements.
We also heard from many of our customers that automation can become a very competitive advantage. Do you agree with this?
Totally. Because when you are able to free time of your talents in order to not to have repetitive, low added value tasks, and free this time in order to dedicate it to more added value, to more analysis, to more insights, you increase the capacity to do much more things, much more added value things. And this is, at the end, more quality work, which is a benefit for our clients. And also for a very simple reason, happy people make happy clients.
And so for my last question would be regarding the future. Can you explain us what are your plans for the next step?
So we want to spread RPA in two directions. Geographically, we want to engage much more country. Today we have around 10 countries involved along the global teams with RPA, where we engage, where we teach, but we still have a long journey to gather much more countries. And the second one is process-wise, to cover more processes. As I said before, today our focus was mainly with finance processes, but we want to cover the whole company.
We wish you a great success in the spread of ERPA in Havas Media.